Hey buddy. Are you doing?
Nice. I bought my new iPhone. That's awesome.
Why some people almost always use iPhone solar chargers?
When choosing a solar charger for your iPhone, there are two basic options: products manufactured primarily for the iPhone, and products that are universal.
Please continue.
There are two main designs: solar panels that integrate with your iPhone, and solar chargers that are separate, with a cord linking the two.
Any product examples?
Sure. NavaThink is the first licensed solar chargers for the iPhone. Other chargers, such as Solio, Lenmer, and Freeloader, either use a device that is attached to the bottom of the iPhone, or have a linking cable that keeps the devices separate. In the off chance you want your battery juice served medium well, yet your iPhone kept on a cold plate to the side.
Wow. Are they reliable?
NavaThink provides 30-60 minutes of talk time after 2 hours of solar exposure. Solio boasts 15 minutes of talk time per hour of solar exposure. Lenmer, with a charge time of 4-6 hours, give a run time of an iPhone around 1.5 hours. Freeloader, with 8 hours of solar charge, can charge an iPad for 18 hours.
Customer reviews for these products were partly cloudy, and many people may need to test drive for a few days to see if the solution is right for them. Going green is definitely a newer phenomenon in the marketplace, and companies are answering the call. The difficulty is being able to distinguish a genuinely reliable alternative energy source from those that are just looking to make a quick buck.
Gotcha.
Now let's chat on Facebook.